Hello friends, in this session we are going to discuss how do we convert our ER diagrams in the form of relation tables. So in this case, we just discuss how do we convert various components of an ER diagram in the form of relational tables, and that entirely solves our purpose of converting an ER diagram in the form of our relational tables, right, or relational schemas. So I've taken a couple of examples for the various possible cases, and then we discuss this particular concept. So let's start with the first one. For example, let's say if I need to convert my entity set in the form of tables. Now I can have my strong entity set as well as a weak entity set. Now let's discuss what we do in case of a strong entity set first. So in case of a strong entity set, like I have over here, I have my student entity set. How do I know that it is a strong entity set? Because it is enclosed, because it is represented only with a single rectangular object. In case it was a double outlined rectangle, it would have been a weak entity set. Now in this case, the student entity set or a student entity has four attributes, which are student ID, student name, course and branch. So what you need to do over here is just simply you can put all these four attributes as the four columns of your relational table, and you can name the relational table as the same as the entity name over here. So your new relational table now becomes as the student relational table with student ID, student name, course and branch as the various columns of this relational table. So next we move on to the next case, which is composite and multi-value attributes. Now over here the attributes were just single valued. So what happens in case we have multi-valued attributes? What I mean by multi-valued or composite attributes, multi-valued in the sense, let's say if I have an attribute as a hobby which has multiple values like cycling, singing, etc., etc. And in case of a composite attribute, which is more important to notice, what we have is we have an attribute split into further sub attributes. For example, over here I have represented my student name split into two sub attributes, I can say, which are the first name and the last name. Now what do I do in this case? How do I represent my relational table in this case? So what I do is I just forget about this main attribute, since it is already represented by the sub attributes. So I just take up these sub attributes as the main attributes now. So now in this case what I have is I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 attributes, and my entity is the same, which is the student entity. So my new table becomes this. So I have the student table with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 attributes, which are student ID, first name, last name, course and branch. Next comes the representation of a weak entity set. Now let's say I have a weak entity set, which is the payment, which is associated with your strong entity set. As you all know, that weak entity set never exists, never has an independent existence. It always exists when it is associated with a strong entity set, right? So over here we have it existing with our loan, which is a strong entity set, and this is our identifying relationship, right? The relationship linking the strong entity set and the weak entity set is known as your identifying relationship, because it provides an identification for your weak entity set records, you can say, weak entity set tuples or records. So over here what we have is we have this payment weak entity set and the loan entity set, which is a strong entity set. Now although I have underlined this, this is not the primary key. As you all know, the weak entity set never has a primary key, so this basically acts as a discriminator for a subset of the records present in this, right? We can dig into the details if you want. You can just ask me to drop a comment dropped below to put a video on this with explaining what a discriminator is, in case you actually find the need of it. So over here let's just concentrate on this diagram first. So what we have is we have a weak entity set and a strong entity set. Now how do we represent this weak entity set in this case? We have the focus over here. So as we all know, this cannot exist independently. So if you remember something about this identifying relationship, what is this identifying relationship composed of? So it just has this loan number and this discriminator acting as a combination over here. So we are going to use the same concept. What we do is we take all the attributes of this weak entity set, since we need to represent this, and in combination to that we take the primary key of this strong entity set. So the final table in this case is this. As I discussed, it contains the primary key of the strong attribute set and all the other attributes of the weak entity set. So this is how we represent a weak entity set. Now let's move on to the other important concept, which is a very important part, which are the relationships, right? How do we connect the strong entity set and the weak entity set? So we always connect it with the relationship as we just discussed right now. So now in this case, what I discuss is that we have basic three types of relationships, which are many to many. Basically there are four: many to many, one to many, and many to one, and one to one. So in case of one to one, it is very clear we can always represent the relationship set if we want with the help of our primary key, with the help of a combination of primary key from the strong entity sets of both the connecting ones, right? So we just take the primary keys of both the participating entities and form it as a table. So now in case of many to many relationship also, we represent it in the same manner. So over here what we have is many to many relationship is there, and we have this two strong entity sets participating. So we just take the primary keys of both the entities, we take the customer ID and loan number as the combination, and this becomes our new table. Now what happens when we have a one to many or many to one relationship? The interesting case is over here when we have a total participation from one end and a partial participation from the other. So over here what we do is this one is which represents our attribute with a partial participation. So what we do is we take one of the attributes from here, which is maybe which is actually the primary key of this, and the other attributes of the one which is in total participation. So you just take all the attributes of the entity which is in total participation into the relationship and the primary key of the other attribute. Now this becomes your new table. So that's all for the concepts relating to the conversion of an ER diagram into a relational table. I hope this would have actually been helpful to you by solving some of your doubts. In case it did help you, please like the video by clicking the like button below and keep subscribed for more good work coming up. Thank you.